dine with thee, to eat from your table. I'm grateful for it's not everybody that have this opportunity. Receive me your name, and Lord, be praised and adored in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Father, I, you know, I am a dust. Therefore, I know nothing for this. I decree that you increase. I step out, I step in, I step down, I step up, and take over the pulpit to talk to me and your children this morning. At the end, oh God, our life will not remain the same in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, I bring my fire before you from my mother's womb to this very point of my life. Daddy, that's some word you have against me. Daddy, I ask that you forgive me. Please, I am sorry. Dip my heart, soul, spirit, and body, my garment, or my fire in your blood. And make me completely whole before you. Don't let me stand here speaking in sin. Obtain holiness and righteousness. And as many of your children that are also having one error in their life, that you have some word against, please have mercy on them all and dip us all together in your blood. And make us whole. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we pray. Amen. Let my heart and the heart of your children be subject to you. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. John chapter 13, verse 27. John 13, verse 27. The Bible tells me and you in verse 27 of John 13. And the Bible says, and after the supper, Satan entered into him. Then said Jesus unto him, that thou doest, do quickly. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That thou doest, do quickly. By the grace of God this morning, the message before me and you says, whatever you need to do, do it quickly. Although the Lord was referring to a particular issue that Judas Iscariot need to do quickly. But the question to me is, why did God act quickly? It means there is time for everything. The reason why he said quickly, because you know something may change if it's not done quickly. You know that something may come across. So that is why I tell Judas Iscariot, hasten up, do whatever you need to do, that thing you have in your mind to do. Do it fast, because there is no time anymore. Time is up. The time you are is an injury time. Just so name it. So do it quickly. But in another way, what is the Lord telling me and you? Or what does that mean to you? I don't know what I and you are doing in the vineyard of God. Whether good or bad. Despite, other disciples never know what Christ was talking about when he told Judas Iscariot to do it quickly. Like, as we know, they were thinking, go and buy things because he was the one holding the money. Go and buy things quickly because we need to feast. But Jesus Christ was having another agenda, another thing in his mind, which others don't know. And the Lord is talking to me this morning that whatever I need to do, I need to do it quickly because the time is up. Is it good thing I am doing all I want to do? I should do it quickly because time is coming. That good thing I wish to do, I will not have the time to do it again, even though I am alive. Is it the evil plan I have? I should do it quickly because if time comes, I will not be able to carry out the plan again. And that is why the Lord is telling me now, whatever I am doing, for example, am I interceding? Do it quickly because very soon you will not be able to intercede anymore. Are you an evangelist who always go to evangelism? You should do it now because time will come. You will want to go to evangelism. You will not be able, even though you are alive. As we must understand that the world we are now is different from the one we had in 2019. And as we know, there are things that is going on that secretly that we don't know, and which is about to play up, just as we see how the coronavirus came up unknown to everybody. Instantly we see different thing everywhere, the whole world. This one lock up, the other country lock up against each other, and everybody go to London at the same time. In the same manner, the Lord is saying, whatever you are doing, you should do it quickly because the time is up. Do you know how to evangelize? Do it quickly. Because time will come, you will not have the opportunity again. The prayer they asking you to come and pray now, every so time, come and gather to pray. But you are saying no. There is time, a time will come, you will be looking for that group, you will not see. By the grace of God, when there was lockdown just now, the whole churches were locked up and we were in Zoom. See, talking to each other, I can still call you, you can still call me, I can still talk to you through Zoom, you can still talk to me. Do whatever you are doing quickly. Come, today there is a meeting this morning. Holy Ghost hour is 6 o'clock. Service is 11 o'clock. You are Lord Disney, you are relenting, you are saying you are tired. A time will come whereby you will be looking for that 6 o'clock to gather with to see me and for me to see you. You will not be able anymore. That is why the Lord is saying, whatever you need to do now, do it quickly because the time is up. Very soon, as I said, I will not be able to see your face again. Very soon, you will not be able to see my face again. If you are with your wife, you will only be with your wife and children, seeing their face alone. If it happens, you are in Europe and your parents are in Africa, wherever. Very soon, you will not even be able to hear from them anymore. You not to talk of seeing their face. That is why whatever you know to do, are you a disobedient person? Do it quickly. Because very soon, the person you are disobeying, you will look for him to disobey. You will not see him again. It will be over. Then disobedience will not be only for you alone. Whatever I need to do, I should do what? Do it quickly. Is it evil? I should do it quickly. Is it good? I should do it quickly. If it is killing, do it quickly because very soon the gun you have hiding under your bed to kill, you will look for who to use to kill, you will not see. Then you will not use it for your own self. Praise the name of the Lord. There is time for everything.
That is why the Bible tells me and you in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3. There is time for everything. The Lord is talking to me. The Lord is talking, he may be talking to you, but I know he's telling me my store business. Since brother, pray. My son, get up from your bed and pray. I am saying, Lord, you know, I have labored throughout the day. And I have done this, I have done that. Very soon, I will not have, I will try to do it. It will not be possible anymore. So therefore, the Lord is saying, the Bible tells me in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3, we read from verse 1. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. What is the purpose you have in your mind? What is the purpose am I having in mind? What is that purpose are we carrying about? The Lord is saying that purpose, utilize it quickly. Utilize it quickly because very soon you will not be able to utilize this something, that purpose you have. Oh, you before the purpose in your hand is to praise, worship God, is to sing to God daily. And now you are related. Very soon you will want to do that praise and worship. You will not be able anymore, even though you are alive. The Lord is saying to me now, there is time for every purpose that every under that is under this heaven. He said in verse 2, a time to be born. You were born into this world a time. And a time to die. No matter how you try to do it, so you have beginning, you have end. That it will tell you. Whatever you are doing, you start it a day, and a day will also come, you will also end it. So therefore, am I doing? I should do it quickly because time is up. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill. Kill now if you know how to kill quickly because very soon you will not see somebody to kill again. You, for example, a police, you always arrest people. Very soon you will not see anybody to arrest again. So whosoever you want to arrest now, arrest quickly because very soon you will handcuff yourself. Because since you don't see anybody to handcuff anymore, you will do it to yourself. That is it. Whatever you know to do, brother, sister, do it quickly. Yes, that money you used to steal from people, or you used to steal from the office boss, do it quickly because very soon the church will close. Then there will be a place for you to steal offering anymore. Everything there is time for it. You know how to preach. Pretty quickly, because very soon you'll be looking for me to preach to. I will be looking for you to preach to. I will not be able. I will only be preaching to myself. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And the Bible tells me in verse 4, a time to weep and a time to laugh. Are you weeping now? Weep quickly, because very soon you will want to weep. You will not be able to weep anymore. Because it's the time of weeping has over. And he said, a time to laugh. Do you know how to laugh? Laugh it quickly, brother Samson. Because very soon you will be looking for laughter. You will not see. You want to open your white teeth. If because of that, brother, you know, whenever you open your white teeth, and that sister will say, your teeth is very white. That your brother will say, your teeth is very white. Very soon, I will open it. Nobody will be there to tell me it's white anymore. So therefore, do I know how to laugh? I should laugh what quickly, because there is no time. There is time for all. There is time for everything. It's a time to mourn. Are you mourning? Do it now, because very soon you will not see if at all you mourn. Although you are mourn now, people are around you comforting you. A time will come, you'll be mommy and nobody will be there to comfort you. So therefore, now that people are around you, do it quickly, because there is time for everything. And a time to dance. Do you know how to dance? Dance now, because very soon the music, the computer, the YouTube, all of them will be off. Your CD will be useless. The CD you used to play, the computer you used to listen to the music, music will be distorted, and you will not see how what to dance again, because that time you want to sing on your own, but you will not be able. So therefore, whatever I need to do, I should do what I should do it quickly. Whatever you need to do, do it quickly, because there is time for every purpose that is under what? Under the heaven. In verse 5, it said, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. Oh, embrace now, sister. Forgive her. Forgive him. Embrace him and continue. You are saying no, no problem. A time will come when you want to embrace that sister. You'll be looking for that brother to embrace. You will not see him or her anymore. It will be over. Despite you are still on earth, it will not be between you and yourself and God alone. But what will become of you that time? What of if it is by death? What? Who? Hey, okay, let me go and embrace. Okay, I am sorry. I will embrace now. It will be over. And the Lord will say to you, and when I was telling you, she's my daughter, embrace her. Forgive her. You say no. There's no more time to embrace now. You only, all that is remaining for you is to face your judgment. So, whatever you need to do, sister, forgive her. Brother, forgive her. I will not forgive her over my dead body. That dead body, you want to use that dead body now to look for the brothers and sisters to forgive. You will not see it. So, whatever you need to do, whatsoever you and I need to forgive, forgive now. Quickly, not even only forgive now. Forgive it quickly. You know why? Time will come. You will be looking for, where is his phone number? You will have the phone number, but you will call his number. There won't be a response anymore. They will only tell you the phone is what is straight off. What will become of you then? Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. But the Bible tells me, are you? He said, a time to cast away stone and a time to gather stone together. Whosoever you want to gather for the kingdom of God now, is it your own family? Gather them now, because a time is coming where you will try to do it. It will not be important anymore. You will not even be able to do it. And the Bible tells me in verses, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep, a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sue, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. Make peace now. You say no, you will not make peace. Very soon, you will be looking for the person to make peace with you. You will not see. That is the issue. That is the truth of the matter. That brother, they are telling you now, go and make peace with him. Go and make peace with that sister. You are saying no. Who that person? Is the person up to my age? Is it the talent I have? Does she or he have it? Hey, let it go. Then very soon, you will be the one who will be using your own teeth to count your tongue, to count your teeth, looking for how to go and look for make peace now. But it will not be possible anymore. So who is that person you want to make peace with right now? Make peace now, because it is going to be over very soon. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible tells me, and you, it said, pray that your flesh will not be in time of winter. Pray. When this one world government and so on and so forth meet you this way, Now that you say you think you are all, you cannot make peace, you cannot forgive, you will pity yourself there. But what will become of you? What will be the next move for your soul? Your soul will be in danger. Your soul will be in danger. Who will do your restitution now with that sister, that brother? You say no. Don't worry. Very soon, you'll be looking for how to go about now. That police, the government you are afraid of, or you are saying it's okay, there's nothing, let me move on this way. You'll be looking for how to go and meet the government now, to all the police that you are afraid of or whatever. You will not be able to do it. Do it quickly, whatever you need to do quickly. Is it with that brother? You want to make restitution. You want to do restitution with that brother or whosoever. Do it quickly, because there is time of, the Bible said, when the bridegroom came, the door was shut. And when those men were not knocking, they told it to them, no, the door is already locked. Very soon, the door will be locked. But what will become of you? What will not be your next cry? What will not be your next move? That is the question you and I should ask ourselves, because there is time for every purpose that is what under heaven. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible tells me and you in the book of John chapter 9, verse 4. John 9, verse 4. Don't have as well. He said, I must walk the walk of him that sent me. Why it is day, the night cometh, when no man can walk. Will you do the walk now? Or you wait for the night to come? What walk are you doing for the Lord? What is that walk God has placed in your mind, in your hands? And you are sluggish about it. When the night comes, it is written now that you can no longer do it. When the Bible tells us night, does not mean the night that we just passed through now and we are here. No. There is night for everything. For example, you open a store. The time you close it is the night. When that shop is closed, that is the night. That time they have closed. Oh, yes, that is the night. The Lord is saying, even Christ was saying, I must do the work. He know. Our maker know there is time for everything. But the unfortunate we that is saying we are his follower, we don't know that there is time for everything. What is the work am I doing for Christ? What is the work you are doing for God? Why not do it now? Now that is day. Because night will come very soon that you and I can no longer walk, do the work, and it will be over. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Come and save me. It's time for service. Do it. You are saying, and let me sleep now. Very soon, you will be looking forward for the sleeping. You want something? We say sleep now. You will be the one to say, I don't want to sleep anymore. I don't want to sleep anymore. Because why? You have found out that the time for that is over. But will there be opportunity again for that you were supposed to do? That is the question. Whatever work I must do for God, I must do it now. I remember a man from America, he said, hey, Donald Trump, ordered the church to be open. So if you know you want to, any soul you want to win for God now, win it quickly, because very, very soon you will not be able to do it. That is exactly what the Lord is saying now. What is that thing Christ has placed in your heart to do for him? and you are withdrawing from it, very soon you want to do it. You will not be able to do it. Yesterday, by the grace of God, we were going somewhere. And me and the man of God were saying something. And as he said something, he said, anytime we have opportunity, we should, something like that, we should use it well. When he said it, I remember the message that we are talking about now. When opportunity comes, make use of it. The opportunity we have now is this time. Very soon you will be taken out of your house. Very soon I don't want to take the vaccine. You will be dragging out of your wife or your children, out of your husband. But what will become the next step? What will be every opportunity we have, we must utilize it well. Or else we find ourselves to blame. It's the opportunity come, according to the Englishman. It come once ago. The opportunity to do whatever we want to do for God now is now. Sister, let us fast. This week we are going to do a 5-day fasting. My sister, I am so weak, I am tired. Very soon you want to do the fasting, but you will not see it, you will not be able again. Brother, get up and study the Bible. I am so tired. I am so weak. I will not be able. God understand. Very soon that Bible, you will look for it when it is taken away from you. Your phone. I know many of us have advantage of reading Bible in the phone right now. Very soon, when your phone is taken off, your Bible is taken away from you. I will not see what you are going to study. That sleep you think you cannot overcome now. The sleep will by itself disappear. The Bible you must study now. The time God is saying, use it. I want you to stay for 3 hours and study my word. You are saying no. Very soon you will be telling God, I want to do it now for 5 hours. But it will be too late. Do it quickly now. Sister, my daughter, my son, I want you to fast throughout this month. My God, you know now, you are complaining. No problem. Very soon, you will be the one to take off. I want to do it for 2 months. But it will not be important again. So whatever I need to do in the vineyard of God, I must do it quickly. For Christ will tell Judas, he cannot do it quickly. He tried to let Judas understand that there is time for it. Quickly. If that is was not so, he would not tell him quickly. He would only tell him, do it. But he tell him quickly because there is time for it. When the disciple, he took them to the garden to pray. Because it was over. When he went and prayed, he returned, get up and pray with me. They continued sleeping. He come to the time when he now know that the time is over. He tell them, rise up now. It's over. They are here. The people I wanted to help me to defend before, they are here now. So there's no need for, I don't need your prayer anymore now. May you get up now. Let us go. That was the issue. That is the same thing we are talking about now. Sister, brother, what will be the next moon when it's now left? You are now left alone. That is the question. The Bible tells me as you. In the book of Philippians chapter 2, verse 12. Philippians chapter 2, verse 12. It said, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Do you want to walk out your salvation now? With fear and trembling, do it now. Because very soon it will be very difficult. It will be very difficult. The fasting, like as I said before, that you are asked to fast, you are saying you are complaining of so much. You will fast it very soon, but it will not be important. You cannot stay for 1 day without eating. but very soon you will stay for a month. You must have that in mind. The one day the Lord is saying, take, I want from you. You are saying no now. Very soon you will stay a week. A month will be gone. Whatever I need to put in order in my life, I must put it in order now. Whatever I need God to help me off in my spiritual man, I have to go to him now. So that I will not say, when I was asking you to come so that I can help you, you refuse. Go and do it yourself now. He said, work out your own salvation now, sister, brother. With fear and trembling, not when the day is now dark. When the night has now come, that is not the time. Now is the day to work out our salvation. With in fear and what in trembling. Because very soon, you and I will not be able again. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And lastly, because of time, Romans chapter 13, I read from 11 to 14. And knowing the time that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. For now is your salvation nearer than when we believe. 12. The night is far spent, brother, sister. The day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness, not in gambling and wantonness, not in strife and envy. 14. But put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. We see it in verse 11 and 12. He said, and that knowing that a time, that now is a high time to awake. Will you awake now? Because very soon you'll not be able to awake again. Will I awake now? Because very soon I will not be able to awake from my sleeping again. That waterbed that I am, that physical spiritual waterbed that I am sleeping on, that I refuse to get up from now, very soon I will not be able. It will be perpetual sleeping. For now is what? Our salvation nearer than when we believe. Look at the verse 12 very well. The night is fast spent. The night is fast spent. So whatever you must do quickly now, or you must do it quickly. Why? Because the night is far spent. The day is a time whereby you and I cannot be able to do what we want to do again for God. You only be looking, even for you to look through the window, you will not be able again because they are everywhere. God evangelize enough now that everywhere is free. You say no, but very soon you want to pull your head out to see, but you will not be able so that they will not even see you. The light in your heart, you will off it. And want to be in darkness. Because immediately they say that there is light, they must come into the house to see who is there. The time, the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. The light you want to put on her, the holiness and righteousness you must put on her. Do it now, because very soon it will be difficult. I forgot how the Bible said, if they do this when the leaf is dry or green, how will it be when it is dry? The Lord has spoken to me. I believe He has also spoke to you as well as He did to me. I don't know
if we are ready to awake, as the Lord has said, that the time is already at hand, whereby those that want to betray me and you, I want to slaughter me and you for the sake of Christ, they are around. So cook yourself down now. Enter the pot of Christ to cook you down. Enter Christ. Say, Christ, cook me down so that when the time comes, I will know I'm already solid. If you are not solid, strong now, prepare yourself to be strong now. I tell you, when the time comes, you will not be able. So whatever you and I need to do, brethren, let us what? Do it quickly. But let it be that what the Lord is saying is the right one. The holiness you must put on, and put it on quickly. The sin you must deal with now, deal with it quickly. The thing you must do away with now, do away with it quickly. The attachment, revolve, paint, and whatever you must do away with, do away with them quickly. The boyfriend, are you out there? The girlfriend, you must do away with now. That's why that marriage you are into, you know you are a second wife, and you call yourself a Christian. If you must do away with it, do away with it now quickly, because time will come, it will be difficult. And I pray the Lord will help me and help you in Jesus' mighty name. I want you to talk to God and say, Father, I've heard your word. I've heard your word. Lord, I am sorry. Anywhere I have been playing with the work you put in my hands. Anywhere I have been sluggish in your work. Anywhere I've been thinking that the life is in my hand. Have mercy on me. And give me the grace to do whatever I need to do right quickly, so that that day will not come to me unaware. Open your mouth and pray, after which you can take the rest to God in prayer by yourself. And the Lord will help me and help you in Jesus' name. Open your mouth.
Amen. And the Father, Lord Jesus, I give you this voice of the glory. So please, Father, whatever work they are facing my hair, Father, please help me. Help me, Lord Jesus. Please help me, Lord Jesus. Please, Father, help me, Lord Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Continue to take it to God in prayer, as I will also, by the grace of God, do when the Lord gives me the grace. But are you out there? You have heard the word. You have not even given your life to the Lord. Is talking to you, even you too, that the life you need to surrender to Him now, you should surrender it to Him quickly, because very soon you will not be able. Why not submit yourself to Him now? Confess your sin. Give your life to Christ. Tell Him, wake on Him to your life. Tell Him to purge and purify you. Tell Him you are sorry for your sin, for being a prodigal child. Tell Him you are sorry. And after which, we advise you to go further by going for baptism And if you need counseling, or you want the man of God on this mountain to help you out, to help you to undergo the baptism, to be the one to do the baptism for you, please kindly call on them. And the Lord will use them for his own glory to assist you. So as I said before, you need counseling, call. The Lord will, is there to help use them for you as we pray together. Eternal Father, I thank you for the life of this one, so God, who just gave their life to you, who are ready to put this in order quickly now before it is too late. Lord, I pray that you uphold them with your mighty right hand as they have come to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we that have been joking with our salvation, we that have been procrastinating, tomorrow is when we will do it. Hey, I will not be able to do it today. Tomorrow I will study. Tomorrow I will do the fasting. Tomorrow I will do the prayer. Father, have mercy upon us. And help us to understand there is time now for all. Very soon we will not be able. We want to do it all, but we will not be able. God, I plead with you that you help us, oh God, to go now and put our everything in order quickly so that day will not come to us on our way. I beg you to help us, help us, your children, for by strength shall no man prevail. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But I bring myself before you, please. Have I hearted to your word or subtracted? I am sorry. Please show me mercy. May this day not stand against me on the last day. Is there anyone that was angry? Show them mercy. I mean, this day not stand against them at the last day. Into your hands, Lord, we commit our soul, our spirit, our lives, our hearts, our mind, everything that concerns us to help to put our life in order so that we will meet you in glory with joy and not with tears. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Of it to Jesus Christ and not to man. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless the Son of God.